richer than I ever been. The richest that I ever been. The richest that I ever been. Richer than I ever been.
See, everybody in here is either about to enter a storm, in the middle of a storm, or just got out of a storm. So, you know, when you understand that, you can start to change your perspective and not be so woe me and understand I'm in a storm right now, or I see a storm coming, or I just got out of one. When you understand that everybody's in one of those phases, there's a couple of things that it leads me to do. One, prepare for the storm. So how do you prepare for the storm when you know there's a storm coming? Because you're either in one of those phases. So there's going to be another one. Eventually, if you just got out of one, you might be out of one for a while, but eventually another storm's going to come. So for me, a storm that I was preparing for is I was playing in the NFL and I knew that my career was going to end one day. So preparing for the storm for me was putting myself in a position to where I can be successful off the field while I was playing, because I had opportunities to leverage my professional career to help me with things that I want to pursue off the field. So I was preparing for that storm, so now I can stand before you today. And when I retired, a lot of guys struggle with identity, and they don't have any income coming anymore. And, you know, a lot of issues start to come up because of things like that. For me, I was preparing my whole career for that storm. I was beginning with the end in mind. So, you know, one thing that I talk to a lot of people about all the time is, like, the concept of being a professional athlete forced me to realize that I'm in a profession where they're trying to replace me. Every year, they either drafted another linebacker to take my job, picked a free agent that they wanted to sign. There's a young guy that they already drafted that they're trying to push on the field more, so taking away some of my snaps. Every year, that's the case, so it's in my face. But I explore that it doesn't matter what profession you're in, so including you guys, there's somebody trying to take your job. And when you have that mindset, then it kind of shifts how you think about things. How do you protect your family financially? How do you, like, I heard Stephanie say a lot of you guys are asking about investing and are thinking about investing and stuff. To me, that means a lot of you have the right mindset, because it's great, and I want you guys to excel and be great real estate agents, but there's some young agent fresh behind the ears trying to take your listings and take your clients. So if you understand and recognize that, how are you building your business in a way to, one, make sure they can't take your clients and stuff, but also eventually, you know, you're going to phase out. You're going to get older. Life circumstances are going to come. You're not going to be hitting the pavement as much trying to get new clientele. So how can you invest in ways to protect yourself for those moments? So when the storm comes, you're prepared. That's just an example of things you need to think about. And when you know storms are coming and you know you're in one of those phases, it's like, are you going to let it make you, or are you going to let it break you? Because the storm's coming. You're either entering one, in one, or just got out of one. And you have the choice of either letting it make you or break you. And how you deal with the day-to-day and the stuff we talked about, flipping the bag, and the stuff believing in delayed gratification, those are the things that help you allow the storm to make you and not break you. So whatever phase you're in, if some of you guys are in the middle of the storm right now, I want to encourage you to keep fighting the good fight, keep believing in delayed gratification, keep flipping the bag. And when you come on the other side of this, you're going to be amazed at what you can accomplish. And if you're stressed and if you're like, I don't know what 2024 is going to look like, I want you to trust in your abilities, because I don't want you to be in a place where you have the same levels of anxiety, of fear, of anger, because I've been there before. I know what that looks like. I know what that feels like. And, you know, you don't have to go to that place if you're doing the right things and you're putting yourself in position.
I done made sacrifices.
I.
So many sacrifices.
Straight up.
I done gave up so much free time, knowing time ain't free.